The Esnoga is a gem of a synagogue in the heart of Amsterdam. The word itself means synagogue in Portuguese, which begs the question, what is a Portuguese center doing in the heart of this Dutch capital? You see, Jews left Spain and Portugal during the Inquisition. They ended up in Antwerp until it came under Spanish rule. Then, the Jews left again, making it to the safe haven of Amsterdam, where three separate communities developed. But it wasn't long before they united under the name Talmud Torah in 1639, and became known as the Portuguese Jewish Community. They most probably dropped the Spanish part because, well, the Netherlands was fighting Spanish control. Not so great to associate with your host's enemy. But as the community grew and a large synagogue was built, the Portuguese connections continued. Like community announcements that to this day are read in Portuguese. It might seem out of place as they made their home in the Netherlands, but just imagine that in the 17th century, the congregation even led prayers in Portuguese. The community was made up of conversos who were baptized and worked hard to hide their Judaism. It took a while until they once again learned Jewish ritual and, well, Hebrew. But the language of the announcements is not the only thing that remains. Construction of the current structure was completed in 1675. It has a style so unique it has been copied in other communities worldwide, such as in New York, London, and Curaçao. Like the Teba, that is located in the entrance of the synagogue, rather than in the center or by the ark. This placement of the Teba follows the writings of Yosef Karo, author of the Shulchan Aruch. Only his writings came at a time and place where synagogues were much smaller and people could still hear the prayers, even if the Teba was at the entrance. Not necessarily the case in the Grand Esnoga. Another unique feature is the sand that covers the Esnoga's floors. And no, it's not because they haven't swept them. It's actually an old Dutch practice for keeping the wooden floors clean. You see, sand absorbs water, dirt, and mud that may be carried in on the shoes of guests. Still, it doesn't mean there aren't various other suggestions for the meaning behind this Esnoga practice. Like that it is a remnant of the conversos who covered their floors in sand, what would muffle the noise made indoors so that the sound of the prayers would not be heard outside. Or that it references the crossing of the Red Sea in the sand, or the 40 years the Israelites spent in the desert. Some even mention God's promise to Abraham that his descendants be as numerous as the sand of the seashores. Either way, the sand is as intentional as it is unique to the synagogue. And if you think about it, still more remarkable is that the synagogue survived World War II. The community was not spared the horrors of the Holocaust, but the Esnoga was. Just prior to the Nazi invasion of the Netherlands, the synagogue was declared a historical site by the government. A group of 40 community members then agreed to patrol the building during the war. Its treasures were kept in between the sanctuary's ceiling and attic. Oh, and the patrol brigade convinced the Nazis it wasn't suitable as a Jewish deportation holding pen. Quite a series of fortunate events for the Esnoga. Which is why it can be seen, admired, and prayed in today, making the Esnoga, together with the old new synagogue in Prague, the oldest functioning synagogue in the world.